Welcome back. You're still watching Urban Today. Thank you for joining us and making us your choice this morning. And we are glad you're also joining us on social media at Urban TV Uganda, at Lynn UG3, at Seka Henry. That is on Twitter as well as Facebook. We are live as well. If you go to Instagram, at Urban TV Uganda. My name is Lynn Komjisha. Now, we head into a very intricate and interesting discussion because Uganda is one of the countries whose population, 70% of it, is youth, is the young people. And that is according to research, that is according to world records. We know that most youth under 70 comprise 70% of our population here in the country. That notwithstanding, they face very many changes and challenges. They face many issues. We have problems. Candidates are campaigning and they keep saying there's a lot of unemployment going on. That is why people have come together to, you know, find a way of working things around, of helping youth come up with ideas, of helping youth come and have one voice in maybe addressing, especially unemployment, but also addressing social change and the issues relating to our social change. Joining me this morning is Richard Zulu, the CEO Outbox. Now, Outbox is an innovation and entrepreneurship support organization. Richard, welcome to the show and good morning.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Good morning to you.
Right. Let's quickly look at what is social change. If you involve youth, what would social change and youth mean to you?
Mm-hmm. So let me explain that with an example. If you look at our society today, and you look at a young person, right? Many times there's so much going on around a young person. I could be female, right? I'm in school, okay? And in my society, there's a belief around early marriages and things like that. As a result of that, most probably I've been introduced to some gentlemen somewhere in my community, mm-hmm. With the hope that my family expects me to get married to this young man. But at the core of it all, I'm worried about my education as a girl. I'm worried about my future. Right? And then on the other side, the guy could also be worried about the same things. But because of societal pressures, there is this kind of cultures and norms expected of both of us.
Mm-hmm.
Now, at the core of that, that brings out an issue, for instance, of the early marriages.
Yes.
And we could easily say, oh, I'm this organization, I'm going to preach about early marriages and kind of get that sorted in this community. But the issues we face in our communities are very complex,
mm-hmm.
are very complex issues, and it cannot take just one organization to address those. It
That's
takes
right.
an ecosystem
mm-hmm.
To address such issues.
Mm-hmm.
And so when we talk about social change, those are the issues that we seek to have our young people address in their communities. Those very complex issues that they experience together with other generations of adults.
That's right. Now that you mention adults, I was thinking as you explained that the youth are not alone because they have a cycle. They have from the adults mm-hmm. they are born, mm-hmm. they become youth, and mm-hmm. they are headed into the adulthood.
Mm-hmm.
Now the society is comprised of all that.
Mm-hmm.
Adults are going to influence what the youth do mm-hmm. or think.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, constituting a social change around them
mm-hmm.
means they have to integrate the adults.
Mm-hmm.
They have
Very
to listen
much.
To them.
Very much.
And learn from them.
Mm-hmm.
So if you say social change for youth,
mm-hmm.
where are the adults?
Mm-hmm. So one of the things we really emphasize is that, again, we are all interlinked, right? Youth, children who are youth, the adults, we're all interlinked. And, you know, we have to build a mindset of co-creation.
Right.
There might be norms that existed when I was young, and then I became an adult, and I'm still emphasizing those norms.
Mm-hmm.
But because of many changes, it could be change in government, it could be change in our cultural institutions,
mm-hmm.
those norms no longer apply. But I'm kind of imposing them. And so this intergenerational dialogue
mm-hmm.
definitely always must always happen
yes.
for us to see that social change.
Yes, I agree. So now that we have to focus on the youth who are now the 70% of the population, most of them are unemployed. Mm-hmm. If we break it down, if we look at that 70% of the youth,
mm-hmm.
most of them are unemployed.
Mm-hmm.
Question is, can an employed youth really successfully create social change?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I believe that's why we came up with this initiative called The Stage.
Mm.
So we initially started out in our work together with our partner UNFPA, where our mandate was around the sexual reproductive health and rights, which is the well-being of a young person.
That's right.
With regards to their sexual reproductive health.
Very key.
Together with many other partners.
Mm.
And then we tasked them and said, okay, could you innovate around social change, right? But again, when you look at myself, by the time you tell me to stop early stage pregnancy, by the time you tell me to stop gender-based violence, there are very many underlying causes to that. And unemployment is one of those, right?
Mm.
And so with the stage, we are looking beyond our mandate and saying, can we have a convening of actors? Right? Can we have a convening of actors where some actors, their work is to expose our young people to work opportunities? Can we have a convening of actors where for some of them, it's ensure the reproductive health well-being of these young people? Can we have other actors where it's to help them become enterprising? So without looking, we have to start looking at a young person as a whole, you know, in terms of, yes, you want to address this issue with me, about me, but what about other underlying causes? How are you linking me up to opportunities, for instance, for work,
mm-hmm.
right? So that then my mental well-being is settled. Then, as my mental well-being is settled, you can tell me about other issues that I have to pay attention to.
Mm.
So it's not just about employment, but it's about a multitude of issues that have to be addressed when we are working with our young people.
Right, before I can ask you what multitude of issues those are, what are the components of social change?
Mm-hmm.
And you mentioned actors
mm-hmm.
in this, you know, coming together.
Mm-hmm.
Who are these actors and what role are they playing?
Mm-hmm. So with regards to the stage, we've looked at, you know, how we support or address social change issues from a number of perspectives, right? The first is around the creating. We have young people who seek to kind of be leaders in terms of how they drive this change in their communities, but they don't have a platform where they can receive this support, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so the stage is meant to be that platform where we link them up to actors that can help them realize their ideas.
Right.
Then we have the engaging, where I might be doing something in my community. It could be a business, or I'm trying to get an education, but I need to talk to someone, right? And so with the engage pill of this initiative, we've opened up mentorship, where we bring together actors who are the subject matter experts within these communities to kind of share for free with the young people utilizing this platform and offer them internships and offer them volunteerships in their communities.
Mm-hmm.
And then the third, we have the convene, meaning how do we bring together these young people to participate in initiatives that we have. So for instance, one of our partners, Reach a Hand Uganda, always has the Young Achievers Awards. How do we get these young people to participate and have a voice in such initiatives. And then the last is the showcase. And here we should not underestimate the value of role models. And here, this is why we tell the stories of not only young people, but aspiring models in these communities mm-hmm. that can inspire these young people to take change. So we've, what we're doing, Lynn, is beyond us. It's beyond logos, it's beyond organizations. For us to solve complex issues, we have to start thinking about our collective intelligence, right? These issues go beyond us. So that's why, you know, you have Outbox, you have Reach a Hand Uganda, you have the Uganda Network of Young People Living with HIV/AIDS, you have Public Health Ambassadors Uganda, all coming together to put
with,
our collective
with all that,
capabilities.
With all that resource, with all that partnership, what exactly are you trying to address? Because youth have various issues and they vary.
Mm-hmm.
But what is your what exactly are you targeting? So if they want to do social change in their communities, do you think that's where the problem is?
Mm-hmm.
Must you start from there?
Mm-hmm.
What if they have other challenges?
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing about that?
So let me answer that with an example. We have a group of young people we are supporting in Yumbe District, for instance, right? And this group of young people came together and said, look, we are having our children. Some of them are born prematurely. They're refugees. And, you know, they suffer from pneumonia all the time. And we really suffer with an issue of supplies. And luckily, they were skilled enough in terms of tailoring and things like that. And then they came and said, how could we put together a small baby kit, right, that we can build locally, sell affordably in our communities so that our, you know, babies do not die from premature deaths due to coldness, right? And we supported those young people, right? We invested in them, we trained them, we mentored them, we gave them funding to help them actually realize their ideas. Now, that's an issue I cannot relate with unless I am there in that community trying to create that change, right? So those are some of the types of issues that we have. And then you as a young person could be there and saying, I have no job, right? But how do I get started, right? And so when you come to us, we have what we call volunteerships, where we link you up to some of the interventions we're doing in communities near you by any of our partners to help you build a profile.
Mm-hmm.
And then your question is now, how do I use that profile? Where is the opportunity and how do I use that profile to actually get an opportunity to work, right? So those are the multitudes of issues that we are relating with our young people and trying to walk them through that journey.
Agreed. I will still tell you that the biggest challenge I have seen among youth is financial management skills, financial literacy, and most of them are quick to say, I need startup capital.
Mm-hmm.
But they do not know how to use startup capital. Mm-hmm. And in all that you have mentioned, mm-hmm. I don't hear you saying, okay, so we might be able to give the youth startup capital or financial literacy skills, because this is core. Most youth will say, okay, I have an idea, I don't have money. But they don't know how to use that money. Even when you give them the money, they'll still come back to say, I see. I don't hear you say anything about that.
Yeah. So, again, like I said, this stage, this initiative is a convening of actors, and we all have our different strengths, right? Our different strengths. So, for instance, the example I gave you, in the consortium, this is what Outbox does, right? You come in with an idea, we help you build up that idea, we link you up to mentors, and you receive funding.
Mm-hmm.
But it's much more than money, okay? We have our partner, Reach a Hand Uganda, who has what we call peer educators, who are volunteers within the communities, that support in terms of spreading sexual reproductive health information and kind of helping with driving social change. And then the issue is if you want a volunteership, right? Who are some of the partners? We link you up on the ground to actually help you build your portfolio, right? And then that is another actor. So each of these actors has a different role to play, but it moves beyond money. Because as a young person, you're not coming to the stage only because you want to start a business, right?
Mm.
You might be coming to the stage just to build your skills as an individual, right?
Mm-hmm.
But also you could be coming because you want to build a business. You might be wanting to seek support in terms of counseling and things like that. So this initiative is that place. Right?
Mm.
Access to information is very critical.
Mm-hmm.
And if you can find that access to information online, like on the stage, or offline through the different actors we are working with, then definitely you have an opportunity.
Right. You say it is more than money. We have, I think, a mindset problem.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't know how you're going to preach to the youth that it is more than money when all they want is money.
Mm-hmm.
How are you going to tweak their minds? Are you going to tickle their minds into mm-hmm. thinking outside the money issue?
Mm-hmm.
What do you think is the problem? Is it their mindset, or mm-hmm. is it the lack of money, or is it mm-hmm. the lack of platforms?
Mm-hmm. It's many issues, honestly. It's many issues. Definitely mindset is one of those things. And that's why many organizations that actually have money to the youth try to build other facets around it. Because it's a motivational factor, no doubt, right? But it's not the means to an end.
Mm.
Lynn, if you have money but you don't have access to good mentors, if you have money but you don't have access to markets, for instance, right? That won't get you anywhere. Still, you still have the same problem. You get it, it's misused
mm-hmm.
to other things, rather than creating the social change that you want. And so, again, going back to my point about looking at this young person and saying, how do we make this person whole, is quite critical in terms of how we support young people,
mm-hmm.
how we address their issues, and you know how we help them grow.
Now, Richard, let's look at COVID-19 and, and the youth.
Mm.
It has been such a bad time for everybody.
Yeah.
But the youth in particular have been hit hard as well, because one, their social fabric has gone down, has been affected. It has been affected. Now, you coming together to address youth issues, to influence social change, definitely you are focusing on perhaps what COVID-19 has presented before
mm-hmm.
us. Mm-hmm. What would you say in regard to COVID-19 has been the huge, most disturbing consequence
mm.
for the youth especially?
So COVID-19 has really exposed the fragility of our systems, right? You know, 5 months of lockdown, and if you can see where many of our youth try to earn a living from, are things that, you know, are hand to mouth.
Mm-hmm.
And again, this goes back to our fabric in terms of saying, the fabric of our society, how do we reach Omutuawansi,
uh-huh.
right?
Yes.
Because as you can see, the effects were felt all over the spectrum.
Absolutely, yes.
But definitely young people don't have social security. You know, young people who are living from hand to mouth. If you look at the educational system, it's been affected, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so all these are issues that we are now living with.
Mm-hmm.
But it's very important, again, that we come together. And this is where we get it wrong in this country. That the issues we face,
mm.
again, they're not about logos, organizations. The issues we face are very systemic in nature. That if you don't come together, right from working with an RDC, a chief development officer in the community,
yeah.
all the way to working with a corporate partner and things like that, and kind of build interventions at that grand level of scale, we shall still stay in the same, you can see our health system,
mm-hmm.
right? It's not that it's not suffering everywhere, but because we need to take an interest that this issue, I also have one way or another to contribute to it for these young people.
So what do you think the youth out there ought to do or ought to have done? Because we're quick to blame the youth. They're saying they are bayaye, they have no sense of responsibility, they have no sense of direction, they're easily swayed by whatever happens. But this is normal, I think. I've come to appreciate that it is normal when you go through a stage before you become an adult. Some of them get stuck there.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, what is that social problem that's... you know, many times they say you need to start from ground zero. Like you said, Muntua Wansi, go there, start from there, address the issue from there. We have illiterate youth on that level. We have unemployed youth on that level. We have youth whose lives have been changed by different issues. For example, early marriages. Others are orphaned. Others are... they are named the misfits, social misfits. And what exactly, I still want you to tell me, we want to address A, B, C, D and help youth come up in a, because your platform says it wants to give the youth, it wants to give the youth a platform to hear their stories and ideas and you help them, support them in all that. But that is my core problem.
Mm.
When you look down at it, they're adolescents without a direction.
So, and again, this is what makes the challenges we face today complex. There is no right or wrong answer.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Because we have to see that if we take this new path, you know, where we bring together different actors to work together towards a common cause, what kind of impact will it have, right? If we come together and on the stage, we profile, let me say you, will it inspire another young person somewhere to kind of see that as a career, to kind of learn from your story, right? If we go down to Yumbe and put out a call and say, hey, we have this platform, you know, if you need to access it, work through your CDO, the community development officer, and submit your idea, are we able to look at this idea, reach out to this young person, offer them the necessary support they need, and link them up to opportunities, be them funding, be them mentorship, and things like that, right? So this convening is because of these complex ideas. There's no right or wrong, but the issue is if we came together and put our collective capabilities, right, how would we see that working? And already you see that that's the mindset we've adopted, even if you look at the National Development Plan 3, where government has taken a program-based approach.
Yes.
You have so many ministries working together towards something.
Yes.
It's the only way forward. Other than that, if you have silos in each and every intervention, then we are doomed. We are doomed in terms of addressing these challenges that the biggest population faces within this country.
Well, so in that, he has been talking about how to impact, how to actually tweak the youth mindset into social change, and definitely being a huge percentage of the population, they are an integral part of our society, and they need to be, you know, put together in a set, you know, taken into a certain direction. Now, Richard, tell me, what informed this? Did you go down to all these districts? Did you, for example, sit down and be like, okay, so let me see, what is happening in Mayuge, for example? What are youth doing? What informed the stage? Because as you call it, because, well, he says they're organizing a stage where youth can come and, you know, I guess to share ideas and then find a way of innovating around them and creating entrepreneurship avenues around there. What informed that? You have told me all these things. I'm mm-hmm. still yet to figure out what inspired, what tickled into that?
Mm-hmm. Listening. We listened to the young people. Uh-huh. We work with a lot of young people. And every time you keep listening to the issues, yes, you've given me this, but this. You've given me this, but that. The other day, we were supporting one of the teams that was, you know, working on this very interesting idea. And by virtue of participating, they were experiencing protection issues in their home, right?
What do you mean protection issues?
Because of participating and they are female, you know, the husband was like, but what is this thing you're participating in? And then that leads you to say, okay, in as much as I'm supporting a female entrepreneur, I have to reach and talk to the husband at home.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Those things.
As much as I'm talking to the husband at home, I have to talk to the community so that they don't feel threatened.
Or left out.
Or left out. Yeah? The other day we were shooting a story and, you know, you just fly a drone and people think you're mapping their land. So all these are very systemic issues. And as you see, one thing leads to another, to another. And if you listen very much, you come to the realization that we can't do this alone. We can't stay in our silo. We have to take care of issues to do with protection of young people in their homes. We have to do things to do with their mental health.
Yes.
We have to do things regarding their finances. We have to do things regarding their physical well-being, you know? So if you don't have such a convening of actors where you can share communities, share experiences, share learnings, and kind of focus on depth rather than just, you know, breadth in terms of, we supported 50,000 young people. But of those 50,000 young people, if I'm to pick out number 1,500, what's their story? And how have you helped this young person?
And how is it impacting the community?
And how is it? So the stage, that's what the stage is meant to achieve, right? It's meant to support and kind of go in depth with regards to supporting and working with this young person along the way. Can they express themselves?
Right.
Do they have a voice? Right? Can they build their ideas? Can they participate in convenings through the opportunities that are invisible that we've made visible for them?
Right. I think as we wind up, Richard, many people have said that the youth are often misled. Sometimes they have ideas, but then they don't know how to address them. Sometimes they're saying, okay, so we do not have support from anyone, from anywhere. I have an idea, A, B, C, D, I don't know how to focus on it. Others are saying, okay, let me sell it to the highest bidder. And oftentimes they lose out. Most importantly, I think it is lack of information. And in our discussion so far, you say there's a convening, sitting, sharing stories and ideas. I don't hear you say we are going to give out information on A, B, C, D, and Z as we wind up.
Yeah. So the stage is both online and offline. So online, if you visit the stage UG.org,
right,
and you actually look at the platform, you'll see a lot of things to do with information. In terms of success stories that we have out there, impact stories, you will see stories to do with information to do with mentors or experts who can help you. This person, right? Depending on what your needs are, you will see information to do with opportunities and internships, right? What can I apply for and get access to? And then you have an opportunity to submit your idea and then receive some feedback in terms of how to make it better and the kind of support you can receive in your community. But again, going back to the grassroots person, each of these partners that we are working with has programming nationwide. And it's a matter of approaching their local office or their local representative and expressing interest in terms of how to participate in the stage.
Right. Richard, your parting shot.
My parting shots, it's just a call out to the youth to utilize this platform on the stageug.org, but also to other actors. It's not limited to youth organizations. We need other actors to be part of this, to be part of this voice on this initiative we started with the United Nations Populations Fund.
Okay. Even the adults can join in.
The adults, policymakers, researchers, you want to research anything, you want to share research, this is the platform for you.
Right. Wonderful. That is Richard Zulu from the CEO Outbox. Now, Outbox is an innovation and entrepreneurship support organization. So if you want to, you're stuck, you're a youth, you're stuck somewhere, reach out to Richard. He might help here and there. Thank you very much, Richard, for making time.
Thank you, too.
Right, so we're going to take a break. Of course, we continue with Urban Today, and we are going to listen to a reporter from, that is Kafuluma Julius, is going to tell us where exactly he is today with the president, what we should look out for, and so much more on the campaign trail. We'll be right back.